What's going on, guys? Welcome back, and today we've got something a little different. You remember Mike, right?
You need a hug. You need a hug. You need a lot of hugs, man, because you keep jumping off, man.
Well, today we're going to do an unboxing, show you his 6th Gen Camaro and what he's got in store. Stay tuned.
So, I ordered the full header and X-pipe system from Speed Engineering. Obviously, it can't all fit in one box. On each one of these shipping container or shipping labels, it says one of two, two of two, which tells you that there's two packages that go together. They don't follow that shit. I came home from work one day, I saw the smaller box with the headers leaning up against the house, and I was like, that just doesn't look big enough for a full headers and X-pipe. So I open it up, it's just the headers. At that point, I'm kind of in panic mode because I paid decent money for the whole setup. There's a lot of package thieving going on around here. I thought one package being missing. Did I pull around the corner as they were grabbing my shit and they dipped out when they heard a car coming into the neighborhood? I don't know. And they only got one box. So immediately I call FedEx. They tell me that, yeah, it got split up from the container and it's coming on two separate trucks. My second package should be there sometime in the week. Or they told me within the next 4 days.
Well, I say that we start opening some boxes. It's like Christmas and I'm ready.
Yes, it is. Speed Engineering, they got a really nice setup. I know they get a lot of flack for being cheap, but honestly, man, for the money that you're paying, the quality of the product is all there. I got the 2-inch primary headers, 3-inch collectors. I went ahead and got the GM manifold gaskets. Got the O2 sensor extensions. And then I went ahead and got the full 3-inch X-pipe system that goes all the way back to the muffler. One of the things that everybody kind of complains about is these clamps. Now, they're thick enough, they look pretty girthy, but they're just not wide enough to make a good seal. So I went ahead and got online and went to summitracing.com. I got the 3-inch wide, 2-bolt system clamps. And there's a little interesting side note to those, and when we unveil those, we'll go ahead and talk about that.
Nice. So this is the whole setup for the, this is the X-pipe in here?
Yes. This is gonna go to the tail part of the car.
Right. That's the section that I took some video of where they've got it all crunched
sandwiched
up.
Sandwiched out.
Yeah. This is gonna make such a difference.
Absolutely, absolutely. Tubes that come off of the primaries.
What size exhaust is this again? Three inch. That's some girthy pipe.
Yes,
what?
Yes, it is. Car is automatic. It's got the A8, 8-speed automatic transmission. It's not a slouch off the line by any means. But later on, the plans for this car are going to be a Pro Charger, so we're going to throw a little bit of boost to it. I got my tuner to go ahead and spec out a nice FTI converter.
That's a nice billet piece, too.
That is a manly converter.
It is.
So what's the specs on this converter?
This is a 3000 stall, designed for boost, obviously. This all comes with brand new hardware and everything, so they did a real good job. Manifold gaskets, extensions.
And the thing with the gaskets, he ordered the OEM ones just because they're the best replacement when you're going to use it.
Absolutely.
If you're going to do it right one time. The worst thing is having a gasket that just ends up leaking or makes a ticking sound and you're trying to figure out what it is. Get the right gaskets. That's why when we're talking about the hardware that he's using here, it comes with the kit, but get the better one and do it right the first time. So, all right, next box.
All right, next box.
Oh, it's a little box.
It's a tiny box.
It's
a tiny box. So this one got open also because I was curious as to what it was going to be like. This is the E85 kit for these cars.
Oh, sweet, look at this.
Yes. So this is a plug-and-play unit as well. So this senses when you have the E85 running through your fuel system and adjust your tune accordingly. I've looked at the instructions. It seems pretty simple. We'll see how it goes whenever we get to that point, because this is on top of the car.
It's amazing how easy it's getting to mod things for certain aspects of it.
Yes, easy, yes, but definitely a little bit more pricey.
Yep.
We'll go ahead and open this up. Now this is before I even open it up, or while I'm opening it up, this is the dual wideband, the exhaust clamps for the speed engineering system, and a couple of nice drinking cups because I do get thirsty. So Summit, I have to give hats off to them whenever I can because first and foremost, regular ground shipping here in the South is next day. I ordered this stuff, if you can get it ordered by 8 p.m. on one night, it will be at your doorstep the very next day.
That's so amazing. That's better than Amazon Prime.
Yeah, it is amazing. I love it. And Summit, you know, they've got pretty much everything that you need.
What is this? Oh my God!
That's a f***ing drinking cup.
That is a cup. Mike, hold that. Even that makes you look small.
Don't do it. Man, I'm going to be honest with you. The bottom of the cup is gripped. You can set it on your armrest in your truck or your car or whatever. It doesn't slide when you go around curves. It is top heavy when you fill it up, though, so make sure you put your arm on it. I have had to stab the brakes in my truck a couple times, and it ends up on the floor. But
what do they sell those for?
$8.99.
Oh, that's not bad.
It's excellent. And I can tell you right now, when I leave work in the evenings or in the mornings on my night shift, I fill this cup up with ice and water, and I leave it sitting in my truck throughout the day because it's going right back to work with me the next morning or the next afternoon, and it is still full of ice and water. That is awesome. That's a good name for it. All right, so this isn't yeah, there it is. So in the reviews, it said for sealing, and I took this the wrong way, obviously. I was thinking that it was gonna be a bead all the way around the sealing surface area, but it looks like what it is there's a sealant right here that's covered up. So when you go to put this together, it'll help you. It helps it stick together, I reckon, man.
Yeah, I think what they're worried about is usually you get leakage up through here coming out.
Okay.
And then that will
seal,
so it makes it one full round.
Very good.
Yeah.
Very good. Thank you for helping me out with that. Because
hold that up next to the other ones. Yeah.
It's a thinner material, but you got more coverage.
Right.
Look at that beautiful part.
All right, what is this?
So, this is the Innovate Motorsports dual wideband air fuel ratio meter. This is a nice quality piece in my opinion. They didn't cheap out on the packaging, obviously. So this is gonna help my tuner dial in the car, man. LS cars, in the past, it's been known for your number 7 cylinder to be the one that leans out. So most folks on the LS cars, 4th gen Camaros and stuff, they only use the single wideband, which goes onto the driver's side of your exhaust. So if number 7 leans out,
you'll know it.
They automatically know, hey, I need to get out of the throttle.
So it's more of a safety thing. Absolutely. Rather than a necessity. You
Absolutely.
Probably could get away with a single. But
yes.
The dual is going to be more information, better tuning capabilities, which means that you'll be more sure that your car is doing what it's
absolutely,
supposed to.
Absolutely. Last but not least.
I'm a little sad that it's the last box.
I know, I am too.
I kind of want, it's like Amazon Prime Day all over.
At least until next year. Hopefully we'll have some bigger boxes, a little bit heavier boxes to open up next year.
Some super boxes?
Yeah, some pro boxes.
Some pro boxes.
Pro charger. Little plug there. So this is going to be the cold air intake, along with pushing a lot of air out with the 2-inch primaries and 3-inch exhaust all the way back in the muffler. You got to have good air in. So we got the Fastech cold air intake system. Reviews online, plus, you know, some extra words from my tuner and a couple other people that have run these. These are the best way to go.
I'll tell you, it comes out looking like a really nice product.
Dude, this is gorgeous, man. Everything's nicely packaged. It looks like a very nice quality setup. Roto Fab. It was Fastech is where I ordered the Roto Fab from. I'm sorry for miswording that, but this is a Roto Fab for the 2016 SS sound tube delete. I'm gonna give them hats off for this, man, because a lot of people, a lot of companies, they'll send you some black and white shit that's where their toner cartridge needed to be replaced, and you
or they don't send you instructions at all anymore.
I will say that about Speed Engineering. There's no instructions in there. I think it's pretty self-explanatory where everything's got to go, but it doesn't tell you where to cut when if you're tying into your stock muffler system.
And so, I think that that's a point that needs to be made, is it would take just a one piece. That could be black and white. Just
absolutely,
to make sure that you know where to cut. You don't want to cut your exhaust and then have to take it to a shop.
Oh, shit,
or
you cut it too short.
Right. Yep.
Yeah, or you got to make several cuts because you're cutting it too long.
Luke, I am your father.
With all the bolt-ons that we've got here, we'll give you a little recap on the performance of the car from baseline. We took it out to the drag strip. We made one pass where I did my burnout. I forgot to turn the traction control back on, so I spun pretty violently coming off the line. Ran a 13. Super disappointed there because I know the car had a ton more in it. We came back around, did a small burnout. I remembered to turn the traction control back on, lined up next to a Challenger. Came out the hole, probably spun about the first 30 feet, and ran a 1265 at 112. Car felt great, even with that little bit of violent spinning or a little bit of traction loss that we had at the beginning of the track. I will say this, for the 8-speed transmissions, they do walk on the big end, huge. The Challenger that I was next to, I jumped out on him. He stayed in a blind spot where I couldn't see him in my mirrors throughout the track. When the car shifted into fourth gear, the Challenger started drifting back. So the car does amazingly. All the parts that we're putting on this car are going to basically complement the efficiency of the car. We're going to have a lot of air coming in. We're going to have a lot of air going out. We're going to lose a little bit of the miles per gallon just because we're switching over to E85. And it's all about the efficiency of the car. Nah, that. We're here to go fast. Nothing else matters.
All right, guys, so many new parts, so much stuff that needs to be done. We need to get to work, and by we, I mean Mike. Hopefully you've enjoyed seeing what this has to do. We're going to follow along through the process. I probably won't be detailing all of the installation, but we definitely will be detailing what it does at the track after all of this. So make sure you like, you subscribe, leave me any comments that you have below, and we'll catch you next time.